Hello, this is Rick Ridings in Jerusalem from Succat Hallel, 24/7, looking out over the Temple Mount and the Mount of Olives and Mount Zion in Jerusalem. I recently had a vision that I would like to share with you. It helps us to know better how to pray at this time. When we hear everything in the news and we can just be moved by that, and I think it's important to come up in worship and prayer to a third heaven perspective. God, what are you doing? What is your timing? What are you doing right now? In this vision, I saw the Lion of Judah sitting on a throne above the Temple Mount. He was so majestic, so sovereign, so absolutely, absolutely in control. He wasn't worried or disturbed about anything in any way. He was just sitting there very serenely, looking to the north, the south, the east, and the west, watching tens of thousands of demons that were feverishly building wooden bridges from the north, the south, the east, and the west toward Jerusalem. And I saw that these wooden bridges, when they got near Jerusalem, they built siege ramps, the kind of thing in the ancient days that they would build around a walled city like Jerusalem in order to get over those walls and try to take the city. And I saw that there was one of these wooden bridges had been built from the direction of New York City and the UN. Another had been built from the direction of Brussels and the EU, going through Geneva and then arriving in Jerusalem. Another had been built from Moscow and Russia. Another from Ankara, the capital of Turkey. Another from Tehran, the capital of Iran. And then the last bridge that I saw was one coming from Pretoria in South Africa, and it was spanning the continent of Africa and coming toward Jerusalem. And it seemed to me that it was saying that these demonic powers were trying to pull Africa into their purposes against Jerusalem. Now, they all arrived pretty much at the same time around the walls of Jerusalem in the vision, and they built siege ramps, these tall things to get into the city, to take the city of Jerusalem, which of course the scripture says one day all nations will be gathered against Jerusalem. And in this vision, it was like they were almost in place to be able to do this great apocalyptic end time battle. But the Lion of Judah was just sitting there so calmly. Suddenly he got down on all four paws and walked down some steps. On each side of the steps, there were six small lions. And as I prayed about what those meant, I felt the Lord said that they represented governmental intercessors on the six inhabited continents who have learned to roar when the Lion of Judah roars. They were quiet when he was quiet. But when he walked down, he started to roar. It wasn't even his loudest roar, but it was definitely a roar. And when he roared, they roared with him. They were synchronized together with him. And then he began walking around, looking at these siege ramps, and he just took his paw and he just went poof, poof, poof. And he just walked around and knocked all the siege ramps over, and these demonic powers were just screaming in fear and confusion, and these siege ramps were falling down. And then I saw the portions of the highways they had built of wood were falling apart. And then I saw that there was a different kind of highway in the heavenlies above what these demons were doing. And this highway was beyond any human highway in terms of stability, way beyond concrete. It was just, I don't know what substance it was, but it was a heavenly highway that was absolutely unshakable. And it came from the north and the south and the east and the west. It came into this region, and I saw that once it came into this region, they went further. It went further, actually, kind of over this throne where the Lion of Judah was sitting. Now, in front of him was an altar of incense, a four-horned altar of incense. And I saw that on this heavenly highway, there were tens of thousands of angels who were going to the north, the south, the east, and the west, to the very ends of the earth. And they were going up and down spiritual stairways from this highway down to wherever there was an altar of prayer and worship that had been built, such as a house of prayer or a prayer group, but any kind of regular altar of worship and prayer. And they were collecting the coals off that altar in golden buckets. They brought them up the stairs on the highways, and they all converged over Jerusalem, and they would pour out the coals, the fire of the worship and the prayer of the saints in all these parts of the earth. They would pour it onto this altar of incense in Jerusalem, which was before this throne of the Lion of Judah, which I saw up above the Temple Mount in the heavens. And when it would come there, suddenly a huge cloud of this incense went out over this whole region that we would call the Isaiah 19 region, the ancient Assyrian Empire, the Middle East, Egypt, and Israel. And this cloud went out and it blinded the eyes of the demons, and they went into disarray, into confusion. They started fighting each other. Their wooden bridges began to crumble and fall even more. I saw that most of them had severe setbacks. It was not that they could not be rebuilt, but there was a big setback time-wise for these demonic plans. I saw in the heavenlies the words, "not yet," and they were being set back in what they were doing. There was only one highway that I saw totally destroyed. That was the one coming from Pretoria, South Africa, across the continent of Africa. The demons on that one just fought each other. It fell apart, and the whole highway was destroyed, and I saw a throne of the Lord begin to come down over the Parliament building in Pretoria, South Africa. So through this vision, I felt the Lord was saying that even though the demons had worked so long to get so many things in place, and we might be fearful as we see all these things coming into place, that very quickly the Light of Judah could just go pop, 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 and set back their plans. And there was a severe setback of their timing, which to me meant a window of mercy over the nations, and it's particularly over this region, that although there might be smaller wars or conflicts, I don't believe there's soon going to be a major Middle Eastern, which would probably become then a world war, an apocalyptic type war. But I believe God is giving more time. And then I saw under the cover of this cloud, little altars began multiplying all over the Middle East. Now, we already work with houses of prayer across the Middle East. We're good friends with them, but they're slow, they're small, they've been at it. But I saw it went into multiplication mode, and that where there just been a few, they quickly multiplied across Egypt, across the Middle East, across Israel. There were altars of worship and prayer that began to be raised up with love and adoration and intercession according to God's purposes. And then it was like I realized it was a time for harvest. It was like he was giving a window of mercy for great harvest, not only in this region, but I believe all actually over the whole earth. I believe that if there were a major Middle Eastern war at this time, it would quickly turn into a major world war. It would cut off a lot of the harvest. A lot of the young men who are called to know the Lord would just be killed in battle. And I believe God has cut something short. And I believe that he has brought great delay into the plans of the enemy. Then the last thing I saw in this vision, the Lion of Judah was back on his throne again, and he pointed with his paw to doorways in the heavenlies. And on the doorways, on these gateways, were certain scripture passages. And I understood in my spirit that when he pushed a door open, it was the beginning of the season of fulfillment for that scripture. You know, decades for the fulfillment of that. The doorway of Amos 9, verses 11 on, about the restoration of the tabernacle of David, the great harvest, the returning of the Jewish people to their homeland, never again to be uprooted. That he'd already pushed that open, and that was in process. Then I saw, secondly, a gateway that had to do with Isaiah 19, this region. That scripture ends up by saying Egypt will become his people. Assyria, the Assyrian Empire covered most of the modern Middle East, would become the work of his hands, and that Israel would be his inheritance. There would be a highway of worship, that there would be something of joining together. So there's something God has already begun to do at the level of believers in this region, bringing healing and reconciliation and worship and prayer together. That's already started. But then I saw a third doorway, which was Ezekiel 36. And this one was not yet open in the vision I had. Again, this vision was on January 30th, 2018. He pushed with his paw on this door, which said Ezekiel 36. that scripture talks, the first part is a prophecy to the mountains of Israel. And the only way you can properly interpret that passage is to understand, if you look at a topographical map of Israel, that the mountains of Israel are almost entirely within what the world calls the West Bank, what the Bible calls Judea and Samaria. And he talks about bringing his people back into those mountains. He talks about a physical and a spiritual restoration in those mountains. I personally believe that that could even mean a great move of the Holy Spirit in such a way, not only among Jewish people who are called to live in those mountains of Israel, but even among many of the Arabs who are now caught in Islam, that could come to know the Lord, that there could actually be a working of God among them in this season. And then the last part of Ezekiel 36 is addressed very clearly to the spiritual restoration of Israel, that even as he brings them back as exiles from the nations, that there's a time where he says, for the sake of my name, not because of anything they've even done. It's not conditional. He says, the only condition is the sake of my name. For the sake of my name as the God of Israel, he said, I will sprinkle clean water upon them. I will change their heart of stone into a heart of flesh. So the rest of that passage is about a spiritual restoration with Israel, within Israel, an awakening within the Jewish people to the God of Israel. So I believe this is a time for us to pray into these purposes of God. I believe it's part of the reason for the delay, that he can, during this 70th year of the 70th anniversary of the modern statehood of Israel, that this could be a year of coming out of exile, like they came out of exile after 70 years when Daniel recognized that Jeremiah's prophecy. I believe that this 70th anniversary is like a spiritual picture of coming out of spiritual exile, coming into a great spiritual restoration, that God wants to move in a very special way in this land this year. So I encourage all of you who are watching this to join with us in praying for this. If you would like to have this vision in a written form, you can find that on our website, which is www.succathallel.com. We just thank all the intercessors from all over the world that he can use as part of his purposes in this city and in this region. Thank you for your prayers.